The Queen of Heaven is so gracious and liberal, says St. Andrew of Crete, that she recompenses her servants with the greatest munificence for the most trifling devotions. Two conditions, however, there are. The first is that when we offer her our devotions, our soul should be free from sin. Otherwise, she would address us as she did a wicked soldier spoken of by St. Peter Celestine. This soldier every day performed some devotion in honor of our Blessed Lady. One day he was suffering greatly from hunger when Mary appeared to him and offered him some most delicious meats, but in so filthy a vessel that he could not bring himself to taste them. I am the Mother of God, the Blessed Virgin then said, and am come to satisfy thy hunger. But, O Lady, he answered, I cannot eat out of so dirty a vessel. And how, replied Mary, canst thou expect that I should accept thy devotions offered to me with so defiled a soul as thine? On hearing this, the soldier was converted, became a hermit, and lived in a desert for 30 years. At death, the Blessed Virgin again appeared to him and took him herself to heaven. It is morally impossible for a client of Mary to be lost, but this must be understood on condition that he lives either without sin or at least with the desire to abandon it, for then the Blessed Virgin will help him. But should anyone, on the other hand, sin in the hope that Mary will save him, he thereby would render himself unworthy and incapable of her protection. The second condition is perseverance in devotion to Mary. Perseverance alone, says St. Bernard, will merit a crown. When Thomas a Kempis was a young man, he used every day to have recourse to the Blessed Virgin with certain prayers. He one day omitted them. He then omitted them for some weeks, and finally gave them up altogether. One night he saw Mary in a dream. She embraced all his companions, but when his turn came, she said, What dost thou expect, thou who hast given up thy devotions? Depart, thou art unworthy of my caresses. On hearing this, Thomas awoke in alarm and resumed his ordinary prayers. Hence, Richard of St. Lawrence with reason says that he who perseveres in his devotion to Mary will be blessed in his confidence and will obtain all he desires. But as no one can be certain of this perseverance, no one before death can be certain of salvation. The advice given by the Venerable John Birchmans of the Society of Jesus deserves our particular attention. When this holy young man was dying, his companions entreated him before he left this world to tell them what devotion they could perform which would be most agreeable to our Blessed Lady. He replied in the following remarkable words, "Any devotion, however small, provided it is constant."